enter this deen, al-Islam, you plant a seed of Iman. So you enter this beautiful faith. It's a seed of Iman that you plant. And this starts growing. And you feed it. And it grows within. It's like a tree of Iman. You feed it with the good deeds, with the good things that you do and the deeds that you offer. And it's this tree of Iman grows inside, regardless of your age, regardless of your status. And it's a fruit. This tree of Iman has fruits. Not everyone enjoys these fruits. Iman is something that you can enjoy if you know how to, and if you take the means to reach that moment of the tree of Iman is flourishing within your heart, yourself, and starts giving fruits. And this fruit starts and it ripes. And some people, when they see a tree, they might come and say, oh, it has fruits. And they pick the fruit and they taste it, but it's not tasty because it's not ripe yet. You see a palm tree and it gives the fruit. The person who doesn't know the reality of this fruit when it ripes, they take it when it's green. Oh, it's nice and green, but it's too bitter. It's not yet ripe. Or grapes, or mangoes, or any fruit. Once it ripes well, and you pick it in the right time, it's tasty and sweet, and you can enjoy it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, realizing that and knowing it, gave us some hints. And he mentioned to us in one beautiful hadith that yes, you can taste the Iman. You can taste the sweetness of Iman. But before I proceed, let me tell you something about joy and pleasure. There are two types of pleasure in this world, right? Maybe not, but this is what I'm claiming. There is a joy that you get it when you really have something physical. People eating something, they enjoy, they like it, they eat it, they enjoy it, right? But you gotta have that to enjoy it. So if you like apples, you gotta have the apple physically and eat it and taste it, so you can have the joy of eating apples or mangoes or bananas or whatever you like, right? So you have it, you taste it, you physically enjoy that taste. And likewise, you can say it about many things. Money, people love money, they count the money, they see the money, they look at the figures in their bank account, they are happy, right? Physically, they have it. Or they think they enjoy that, right? But there is another type of joy. That joy, people can enjoy it, not necessarily having the physical thing. This is what you feel in your heart. When you see someone you love, you feel very happy. When you are away from your family and meet them again, you are happy for that. This is not something physical that you can have or measure. That sort of joy, when you do something good and you bring happiness to somebody, you feel very happy that you relieved someone from difficulty or calamity or sorrow. You feel very happy, right? How you can measure that? What is that figure? that sort of joy is way above the physical joy. And this type of thing, people can have it regardless of their age, regardless of their status, regardless of their state. Maybe they are in pain, but they're very happy inside. Huh? Maybe they don't have the means, but they're still very happy inside. Maybe they don't have the fruit, but they feel the sweetness because of something, right? Because they achieved something. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell us, ثَلَاثٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ حَلَاوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us this hint. He didn't give us a lot. He didn't give us everything, because we cannot embrace everything. He gave us only little, and this little is too much even for us. He said three things. Whoever has it, we will taste the sweetness of Iman. Three things. Let's go through these things. Number one, أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. To feel the sweetness, and to taste actually the sweetness of Iman, look for these three things. Number one, أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. That Allah and His Messenger to be dearer to that person than anything else. So what's the result? Then you will taste the sweetness of Iman. What does it mean for Allah and His Messenger to be dearer to me than anything else? We have to take some examples. Allah says, tells us, حَيَّ عَلَى الصَّلَاةِ. Come to salah, come to success. As-salatu khayrun min al-nawm, right? Allah is calling us, right? Allah is calling us to come to salah, to come to salatul fajr. And He's saying, as-salah is better than sleep. Forget about all medical records that's talking about good to wake up at that time, and you know, it's good for your health, for your blood and your body. Allah says, salah is better now. And the shaitan says, the bed is better. And yourself wants to stick under the, in the bed. So, is Allah dearer to me? Then I'll wake up. And the Prophet ﷺ says, if you wake up, then one knot is unknotted, is relieved. And if you go and make wudu, the second knot will be relieved. And if you go to make, and you make the salah, then the three knots will be, remove, and you will be strong and good in that day. So Allah's dearer to me, then I will go to salah. Allah is dearer to me, then this tender is mine if I pay bribe. If I give something, I will get this tender. Not in the course of normal business actions and competition, but I give some extra money and give this bribe to that and so on, I'll get this tender. Allah says bribe is haram. So is Allah dearer to me or my interest dearer to me? Then choose. That person who left this haram, we will taste the sweetness of Iman. That Joseph and similar, Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, and those similar, whom someone is calling them for haram, calling them for fahisha, calling them for zina, calling them for adultery or fornication. Is my lust dearer to me or Allah is dearer to me? Allah says no. He said, قَالَ مَعَاذَ اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ رَبِّي. Allah is dearer to me, then I'm not going to do it. Something else is dearer, I will give up to that. So Allah says, something else says. Allah says, don't circulate this joke because it's making fun of this nation, of that person. Oh, it's funny. Pass it. You take it easy, lightly. You pass this joke over the net and it reaches another 1,000 person and you take it too lightly. Allah said, don't do it. But your thumbs couldn't help and pass it. Don't do it and you will find the sweetness of Iman. Allah says, stand for the truth, do the right thing. Allah is dearer to me, I will do that. I was ordered to do something haram, Allah says, don't do it. Allah says, la ta'at. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, la ta'at illa fil ma'roof. Obedience is only in something halal. Obedience is bil ma'roof. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, do this, this is my sunnah. Stand for the truth regardless, even if it's against yourself, even if it's against your dear ones. Stand for the truth. Till the, be honest and tell the truth. Stand for that regardless, even if it's going to serve your enemies against you. If it's the truth, if it's to tell the truth, you tell the truth. Stand for that. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, this is my way. Anyone diverts from that is not from my ummah. Allah wa rasuluhu ahab ilayk. Allah is dearer to you. You will feel the sweetness of Iman. Then you leave this haram, for sure you will find this sweetness in your heart. Doing that, go to the next one. وَأَنْ يُحِبَّ الْمَرْءَ لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. And to love the person for none but for the sake of Allah. You like that person because that person is strong and honest, not because that person is of a high rank and he can help me in my whatever. Maybe yes, but regardless of that person is corrupt. You like him because of that? Because he has the means, he has the authority, he has the power, he has the money? No. To like the person for the sake of Allah, something will get you closer to the first one, to Allah's pleasure, to Allah's acceptance. Take this person as a friend, this guy, this colleague as a friend, because he's honest, he's strong, he's good one, he's a hard worker. Yes, Allah loves that. He's a good example. Allah loves that. I'll take him as my friend. I'll take him as my colleague, as my buddy, as my example. Exemplary, not the celebrity that lead to the hellfire, like is happening nowadays. What's been promoted by much of the media, these will definitely lead. أولئك يدعون إلى النار. Regardless how rich they are, regardless how coverage they get, how publicity, how famous they are, Allah says, ولو أعجبكم. Even if you like it, even if you like the person, don't marry him. If the person is corrupt, don't marry him. If the lady is corrupt, don't marry her. Don't take them as friends. أولئك يدعون إلى النار والله يدعو إلى الجنة والمغفرة بإذنه. Whereas Allah is calling you to the Jannah and to forgiveness with His permission. So you choose that way, you will find the sweetness of Iman. You like that person regardless of his nationality, regardless of his belonging. That person is mu'min, that person is a good person, that's honest, he stands for the things, he has principles. I like that. Allah likes that. I'll stand for this. I will side by them regardless of that. And the third one, the Prophet ﷺ said, to have it, you will have the sweetness, or you will feel the sweetness of Iman. وَأَنْ يَكْرَهَ أَنْ يُلْقَى فِي أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ. And to hate, to go back to disbelief, exactly like you hate to be thrown in hellfire. All related, by the way. All three. All the first one is the basis, the next one is the fruit, for your interrelations, and the third one is your inside. You like Allah and what you buy Allah and what His Messenger says, then your interrelations, you take your one as a friend, as a brother, as whatever, because they are in the right side. And the third one is within yourself. Watch what's inside yourself. Are you really a believer? Do you really like to do good things? Are you in love with honesty? And doing good stuff sincerely inside? Really? And you hate to do the sins? This is the real test. You hate to commit the sins just like you hate to be thrown in hellfire. To hate to commit sins. And يكره أن يعود في الكفر. To hate to commit sins. Sins from disbelieving in Allah. To commit any sins. To hate doing the sins. Not to say, well, okay, because I'm Muslim, I cannot do that, unfortunately. This is not true. This is not real Iman. This is helpless Iman. I'm sorry, I cannot drink because I'm Muslim, unfortunately. I cannot date because I cannot. A'udhu billah. This is not someone who hates these things. This is someone who really wishes for that, but he ashamed of the surroundings. No. Allah doesn't want you to be at this too basic level. Allah wants you to go beyond that, to be strong, and to have things offered to you and say, no, I will do it the halal way. I will be patient and I will wait when Allah gives me the chance, when Allah makes it available to me in halal way. I'm not gonna rush and take it from haram. I'm not gonna listen to this whispering that's coming to say, easy going, easy catch, don't worry, everyone does it, everyone says it, regardless. Is it right? Does Allah acknowledge that? Allah will be pleased with me or not? Yes or no, Dad? Yes or no, my friend? Would this please Allah or not? If it does, I will do it. If not, I'll leave it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give me sufficiency. سَيُغْنِينِ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ Allah will give me enough in replacement of that. You say that? Allah is not getting tested. We don't test Allah. We trust Allah. We don't test Him. A believer trusts Him. So while you are in pain, while the things are ready for you in haram and you leave it, you say, I trust Allah and Allah will replace me with goodness. This is the attitude of a believer. This is where you taste that fruit. The fruit of Iman, my brothers, doesn't need 10 years or even sometimes not even 10 days to ripe. It could ripe in the hearts of a 5-year-old, of a 10-year, of a 70-year. The fruit of Iman is something Allah is gifting to you. If you're really sincere, Allah will throw it and you will enjoy it better than the apples and the food and all the enjoyment of this world. This is the taste of Iman. Enjoy it, my brothers and sisters. Enjoy it, my friends, my little ones, my elderly as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our hearts with Iman and with the sweetness of Iman. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. May Allah make this country safe and peaceful, and Syria and Iraq and Yemen and all the lands. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Wa salli lahumma wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.